हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू लेक्चर ऑन आवर सीरीज ऑन डाटा माइनिंग एंड वेयरहाउसिंग। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग बेजियन क्लासिफिकेशन विद नेव बेस क्लासिफायर एंड विल स्टार्ट विद द लेक्चर विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ आवर प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड देन विल गो फॉरवर्ड फॉर बेजियन क्लासिफिकेशन एंड नेव बेस क्लासिफायर। सो प्रोबेबिलिटी वी विल फर्स्ट डिस्कस एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी लाइज इन द रेंज ऑफ 0 टू 1 एंड 0 फॉर इम्पॉसिबल इवेंट and 1 for surely possible event, and in this case the probability value usually rise from the range of 0 to 1, and probability is basically the mathematical analytical value of the event to occur. So what is an event? Event is usually one or more outcome of an experiment. So event is basically a subset of the outcomes of the experiment. Now we'll talk about sample space. Sample space is basically the collection of all possible outcomes of an experiment. Now we'll talk about independent event. So independent event are basically those events which are not dependent on each other. So like if we throw a coin, the probability of head or tail is independent of what we score while we roll a dice. Now we'll talk about mutually exclusive event. Mutually exclusive event are those event in which one happens, it makes sure that the probability of other event is zero. Like let's say when we roll a dice, the probability of outcome is 1, 2, 3 is a one event, and outcome 4, 5, 6 is another event. If a event happens like 1, 2, 3 has happened, then the probability of 4, 5, 6 turns to be 0. And in that case, these events are called mutually exclusive because the happening of one makes the possibility of other to be 0. And the other name of mutually exclusive event is also known as disjoint events. Now we'll talk about classical probability. How it is evaluated? It is basically number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. Then there is empirical probability, which is basically determined analytically based on conducting large number of experiments and fetching the data and analyzing it mathematically to get the value of the probability. Then there is conditional probability. Conditional probability basically is read as probability of A if B has occurred, and it does mean that we are sure that B has occurred. Then we need to formulate or calculate what is the probability of A that A has also occurred. So in case of probability of A is B has occurred, we imply that B has occurred and we are calculating the probability of A. Then there is joint probability. Joint probability is basically probability of A and B together to happen. Then there is marginal probability. Marginal probability of one event is regardless of another event. Like the marginal probability of A is written as probability of A, but it does imply that probability of A if B has occurred is equivalent to probability of B if A has occurred into probability of A divided by probability of B if A has occurred into probability of A plus probability of B if A has not occurred into probability of A not happening. So now we come to Bayesian classification. As you know, Bayesian classification is a statistical classifier which forms it based on probabilistic prediction and on the basis of class membership probability, the class of a particular tuple is identified, and it is based on Bayes theorem. So as you know, Bayes theorem, we have the total probability theorem, which is equal to probability of B equal to I equal to M probability of B if AI is occurred into probability of AI whole summation. So which brings us to the our base theorem, which is equivalent to probability of H if X has occurred is given by probability of X if H has occurred into probability of H divided by probability of X. In case X is a set of mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive event, the probability of X turns out to be 1. So let's suppose we have X which is represented as data sample and H is an hypothesis. So probability of H if X has occurred is known as posterior probability, and probability of H is basically prior probability. So probability of X if H has occurred turned out to be the likelihood, and we have a formula for posterior which is equal to likelihood into prior divided by evidence. I will consider an example where D is a training data set of tuples and each tuple is represented by nd vector. So X equal to x1, x2 up to xn. So what we are here are suggesting that there is n number of attributes and we are supposing that there are m classes. So suppose we are supposing m classes which are corresponded by c1 to c2, c3 up to cn. So now what Bayesian classification does is it maximizes the probability of ci if x has occurred. So whichever class which is getting the highest probability, we categorize the tuple x as belonging to that particular class, and probability of ci if x has occurred is given by probability of x if ci has occurred into probability of ci divided by probability of x. So probability of x is constant over here. So what we need to maximize for our classification is we need to maximize the value of, identify the maximum value of p if probability of x if ci has occurred into probability of ci. This is the way in which Bayesian classification works. Now we are going to talk about Navier's classifier. So here the assumption are attributes are conditionally independent and each have a same effect on the outcome. So all attributes are equally important here in our Navier's classifier, and probability of X if ci has occurred is equal to the product of from 1 to n probability of xk if ci has occurred, which is given by, you can see in the figure, equal to probability of xi if ci has occurred into probability of x2 if ci has occurred up to probability of xn if ci has occurred. So now we are going to take an example where you can find the data set, and you must be familiar with the data set because we have used it in our previous slide. So we have all the four attributes and one classification attribute or basically class. So our attributes are age, income, student, credit rating, and our classification is whether bias computer is equal to yes or bias computer is equal to no. So whenever we get any tuple, we need to classify our tuple into whether the bias computer will be yes or bias computer will be equal to no. Okay, so let's take an example. Now what we have, we have data to be classified as where x is greater than, where x is a tuple which suggests that age is what? Age is less than 30, income is equal to medium, being a student is equal to yes, and credit rating is equal to fair. But we don't have the value of bias computer. So what we need to evaluate is, we need to evaluate the value of bias computer. So what we do, we will first try to identify the probability of belonging to a particular class. So probability of buying computer equal to yes will be given by, we'll calculate the number of yes in the bias computer and we'll divide by the total number of the tuples or test examples which we are given. So what we find, we find that the number of yes in the table R9, and which when divided by the total number which is 14 gives us the probability 9 by 14. And for Pi's computer equal to no, the value is given as no R5, so 5 by 14. Okay, so our probability of yes is equal to 9 by 14, which is equal to 0.643, and probability of no is equal to 0.357. So what we do now, we will try to identify what is the probability of age less than 30 and Pi's computer equal to yes. If you see how there are 9 yes, so we will make a separate subset of those 9 and we will make a separate subset of no's. So if you look at the set where all the Pi's computer are present, the probability of age less than 30 and Pi's computer equal to yes is equal to 2 by 9, and in case of age less than 30 and Pi's computer equal to no, the probability is equal to 3 by 5. Now we'll talk about our second attribute, which was income. And we have in that our test tuple the income equal to medium. So what we do, probability of income equal to medium if Pi's computer equal to yes. So we again have our 9 tuple set in which the outcomes are yes. So we get 4 by 9. Then we'll calculate the same for Pi's computer equal to no subset. So probability income equal to medium, Pi's computer equal to no, we get 2 by 5. Then our third is student equal to yes. So what we do, we find the probability of student equal to yes and Pi's computer equal to yes. So we get 6 yeses in our 9 yes table. So our probability is equal to 6 by 9, and probability of student equal to yes and Pi's computer equal to no, we find in our no table of Pi's computer, where we get 1 by 5. Then our last attribute is credit rating. So credit rating was fair in our test tuple. What we do? We do probability of credit rating equal to fair when Pi's computer equal to yes. So we again look at the 9 yes Pi computer table, and we get the probability 6 by 9. And for no, what we do? We look at the 5 no Pi's computer cases, and the credit rating equal to fair and Pi's computer no will give us the value 2 by 5. So now we have the value of individual attributes, and now we make to relate all these attributes together to form a solution. So now when we talk about a tuple and Pi's computer equal to yes, which gives us the value of 2 by 9 for our age, 4 by 9 for our income, 6 by 9 for our student attribute, and 6 by 9 for credit rating as well. So this value comes out to be 0.044. So probability of x when Pi's computer equal to no is equal to 3 by 5 for age, 2 by 5 for income, 1 by 5 for student, and 2 by 5 for credit rating, which gives us the value equal to 0.019. Now we will try to evaluate the probability of Pi's computer equal to yes. So what will be the probability of Pi's computer, what will be the probability of x belonging to Pi's computer? So it is given by, as we have studied in the formula, probability of x belonging to Pi's computer is given by probability of x is Pi's computer has happened into probability of Pi's computer. Similarly, the probability of Pi's computer x belonging to not Pi's computer is given by probability of x is not computer Pi is equal to no, and probability of computer Pi is equal to no. So our probability of yes, x belonging to yes will be equal to 0.044, which we have evaluated, into 0.643, the probability of Pi's computer equal to yes, basically 9 by 14, which will give you the value 0.028. and for Pi's computer equal to no, x belonging to Pi's computer equal to no, the value will be equal to 0.019, which we have evaluated, into the probability of Pi's computer equal to no, which is 5 by 14, equal to 0.357. so which gives the value of 0.007. So now if you compare the value 0.028 with 0.007, you will find the probability of Bayes computer equal to yes is significantly higher as compared to Bayes computer equal to no. So what we do here is we classify the tuple x belonging to Bayes computer. Since the probability is high, in this manner any attribute plays a role, all the attribute basically plays the role, and we can identify whether any tuple belongs to which class. So this is the manner in which naive Bayesian classifier works. Thank you for your time and support. I hope you have got the idea about probability, Bayesian classification and naive Bayes classifier. In case of queries, you can mail me at utsav@gwca.ac.in. Till then, stay at home and keep studying. Thank you for your time and support.